Good afternoon.
My name is Jonathan. I work for Wecyclers. We've been in the hub for about 6 months since August last year. This is the first time we're showcasing. So I'll just tell you about what we do. So Wecyclers, we work in the waste management industry or waste management scene. Because in African countries, waste management is really a huge problem. I'm sure all of the numbers in Lagos, they say something like 15 million people in Lagos, growth rate of something like 18%, which is huge, and the infrastructure hasn't really been laid out to cater for all these people in terms of waste management. So what we're trying to do is bring in innovative solutions to allow communities to be able to dispose of their recyclable waste in a proper way. So you know, we're all familiar with this problem. You know, wherever we live, waste affects us all. But I think in some communities more than others, this problem is so much more severe. So for example, this is, I want to call it community. It's one of our customers in Ijere, where we launched our first label. So she's a petty trader. She has a small shop outside her house, and she generates quite a bit of waste every week. She has a pure water sachets, aluminum cans, and pet bottles, those kinds of things. And so, you know, what she might end up doing is spending around 10% of her income to pay these informal waste collectors to dispose of the waste. And, you know, on top of that, even this waste disposal, because it's informal, there's no guarantee that you'll end up being disposed of safely. In addition to that, that cost problem, there is also the problem of an immediate environment. So she has kids, of course, and many people have kids. And because of the informal waste disposal, what happens is that the kids play in this kind of environment that causes them to all kinds of things. This is a kind of scene seen in many places. This is some happening place in Lagos, but you can find this in many other places. Me myself, I'm from Nairobi, Kenya. You see exactly the same thing. It really is a huge problem. Informally collected waste ends up in drainage ditches like this. Clog the system. Because of all kinds of problems. Health, it attracts all these rodents, disease-carrying vectors. It even attracts pigs, increasing the contact between human and animals. So that leads to increased risk of disease. Also talk about flooding. That comes in the waste to the property, and the cost that comes with that. But you see many people do things like, you know, many people help themselves in the ditches, for example. And when it floods, all this comes up. So this is not a good environment for the health, for the public health. And it's not an isolated incident as well. You know, Lagos generates something like 10,000 metric tons of waste per day. 40% of this is formally collected. The rest ends up in places like this, you know, in our homes, in our streets, in our society. So we cycle as a public. We're trying to address this problem. We sort of highlighted a couple of problems. One is the cost to people to handle the waste disposal. But you know, it's not only a cost thing and a convenience thing, but it's also a thing of our habits and our attitude. Me myself, I'm a culprit. I can't say I have disposed of my waste in a proper manner at all times. And in fact, in some cases, it's even more severe that people, you know, even if you know it's bad, okay, fine. There are some people who don't even know it's bad. Right? It just is. That's how they've grown up. That's the environment. So that's how they just live. Right? So there's a huge education gap. So what Wecyclers does is whenever we go into our community, first thing we do is try to educate them on this. And we spot the hazards that this informally collected waste, this waste that's exposed to the community. What are the hazards? Those things that I mentioned. Then register them onto our platform, and once we register our households, we'll be going to the houses every week to be collecting their recyclable materials. That's our water sachets, pet bottles, and aluminium cans for now. These are one of our bikes. We're using low-cost bicycles to do this collection. So every week, these guys will go around the neighborhood, collect all this material for X amount of kilograms a household gives us. Give them back points in return. And these points can be redeemed for Wecyclers, of course, are looking for things like basic foodstuffs, rice and the like, and sugar. We also have branded items, carbs. We also have other useful things like solar lights, and if you have enough points, we have things like TVs and TVs, which has those kind of stuff. So the platform we've used to kind of power what we're doing is the SMS platform. So we found that SMS really is the most reachable across the entire society. When they have a smartphone and a simple feature phone, it's very accessible. Most people, everybody, pretty much everybody knows how to use it. The only barrier maybe is the cost. But for now, that's what we're doing. We're using the SMS platform. So whenever recyclers collect material from somebody, we enter the record for that day into our database, which will automatically update the account, calculate the points, and then send each of the households we've collected from the points. So that's the full cycle. The raw materials come into us, we give them points, and then at the end of the day, they can give the points for some good. We also try to use our SMS platform to educate the community. So in addition to just the incentives, which I'll tell you how many points you have, we're seeing how we can move into using it more for education. How can we empower the community with knowledge so that their fundamental attitude towards this can change rather than only them focusing on the incentives. So I look at things like whether it's a weekly SMS saying, hey, do you know that in your area you guys generate X amount of waste, you know, this is how other areas look like, these are the risks you're exposing yourself to. Trying to educate people, see that, hey, okay, this is not good, and moreover, providing them with a solution, empowering them so that they can be active against and try to improve their community. This is an example of an SMS. It's very simple text. On Tuesday, we collected X amount of kgs from you. You have 200 points. We have redemption events after every 3 months. We do have our own records in the database, but they can come and show us the latest text and we say, okay, fine, here's your gift. Mapping, so you know, we realize that we have kind of very unique, we're trying to build a very unique network because hopefully our goal is to cover Lagos. And we started in Ijea, that is still there. This is the area which is now mapped because we find that our recyclers go, hey, they walk along the streets every single day. So our capacity to actually do some very detailed mapping, I think, is really huge. So this, I just pulled this from Open Street Maps, and you see all this area is kind of empty. Google Maps is not too far from this. I don't know, it's not as detailed as this is now, but with our capacity that we're building, hopefully we're trying to generate a more comprehensive map of Lagos and allow communities to use this map as a resource in whatever way they see fit. So that's one of the additional resources we're trying to provide for the community. Okay, so as I was saying, this is not a problem localized to Lagos. Unfortunately, Lagos is the only city in Nigeria I've been to. I'm sure in Abuja, much of the same exists in a few other cities. Myself, I'm from Nairobi, Kenya. As I said, we have a site that's not there. It's a huge, huge African problem. We're starting in Lagos, we're seeing how it goes, and hopefully we'll be able to enter all these areas. So, okay, this is just the concluding slide. I kind of feel this like, anyway, please, our Facebook page needs some likes. If you don't mind me including a shameless plug. I don't know, I'm sure you all support an initiative like this. Sorry?
Recyclers.
Recyclers on Facebook. Just check out our Facebook page. Check out our website. You know, share. You know, you guys don't share the page, because it's over there. Developed a website which has gotten us so much traffic, and the help has been such a great support. Like, just check them out, see what we're doing, look at our pictures. We have Mr. Busayo here who took these pictures. This is actually an event. Yeah, Busayo here took these pictures. This is an event we had. This Saturday, actually, we're opening a new hub in Butenbeta. So right now we're in Surule and then Butenbeta. Yeah, and that's us. Questions, comments, suggestions.
Post change. Mike?
I'm just interested in what it costs you to go around with your friends.
So as I mentioned, we're really trying to take this infrastructure to the community level. So our model is to set up a hub in a particular area. So for example, right now we're in Israel, in Surin area. It's probably not going to be the only hub, but it's just servicing this small area here. In a Ebute Metta, similarly, there'll be a hub which is service a small cell. And we know within those cells, we try as much to hire people from the local community. They know the community. And apparently, it's also a big part of those communities. So we're trying to open this individual cells as different communities and have them kind of micromanage the activities within there. Okay, so after we collect everything, we sell them to recyclers. So that's how we kind of fund ourselves, how we fund the gifts. We sell this material and then buy them.
Another question. What's the long-term plan or goal for this technology in 5 years? How do that involve?
They can do cars, for instance, or in terms of waste.
In terms of waste.
They do start recycling cars.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Did you get this? Because he's asking about a long term waste. In terms of waste. Yeah, I mean, right now we're just focusing on those materials I mentioned because they are so visible in the community. That's the angle we're trying to approach. And things like, we're also limited by infrastructure we have. So we're using bikes now. Heavier things have cost implication as well, which you have to look at. But if there are other materials which we can collect, which are manageable with the infrastructure we have, then we will collect that. So for now, we're just trying to collect whatever is most problematic and whatever we can manage with that. Thanks, guys.
Okay.